don't think that I'd be out.
Well, they've got worldwide record sales exceeding 100 million. They've recorded 44 British hit singles. They've made more than 100 appearances on that British music institution, Top of the Pops, more than any other group. And now with nearly 30 years in the business, they're back on tour. They've just released their new single, Restless. Please welcome Bright as Two Buttons, Rick Parfitt and Francis Rossi, and Status Quo, raring to go this morning.
As you say, raring to go.
Well, tell you, you missed your vocation. You should have been breakfast time presenter.
Yeah, I think you were right.
Mm. When do you have a social life?
I just don't go to bed.
You don't?
I reckon that's the way, because...
Well, you look well on no sleep there.
Yeah. Who's holding your face up then? Someone's doing it.
Liquid lunches.
I'm only 17, I just...
Talking about age,
Thirsty Work is the title of the tour. Is it increasingly thirsty work the older you get doing this?
Not really, no. I mean, the actual physical demand required for the stage set is not too bad, really. We do anything between an hour and 45 and 2 hours, and it comes fairly easy. We've done it plenty of times before. And
it's all the travelling as well that goes with it.
That's the worst part about it. If you could eliminate the travelling and the sitting around, it'd be great, because the actual time spent on stage is fab.
Yeah.
But sitting around and the travelling and bits and pieces...
You better get used to it. You're 2 months gone.
Far further gone than that. You don't worry about that.
At our age, it's dangerous to be 2 months gone. Apparently.
We started off in Barcelona two months or so ago, and Ipswich tonight, Barcelona to Ipswich.
Well, hey, what can I say?
Really.
Now listen, we're going to unplug you here this morning. It's not what they say in the music room. Now you're going to sing a wee song for us called Gerdundula?
Well, if you'd like.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Is that it? Now what does that mean?
No.
We were out in Germany many years ago. We were in Germany and we saw a sign which said Umleitung, which in Deutsch means diversion. So we'd written a song, and we thought, well, that sounds good, so we'll call it Diversion. Then we met this couple, an extremely nice couple. Mm-hmm. Her name was Ulla, and his name was Gert. And we'd written this other song, and we decided just to call it Gert and Ulla.
Oh,
and
right,
put it in one word, right, and it goes Gert and Ulla.
Gert and Ulla.
It's a sort of a gypsified type thing, so the title lends itself to...
I like that tie.
Do you like that?
Especially the condition I'm in.
You said that last time we were on here, you liked his tie.
Well, I like him.
And he gave it.
I can never get round him. I always get that far and then he just blanks me.
I prefer her, actually.
I can see why. I can see why.
Okay, what about a touch of Gerdundula?
Oh, my God.
Hold on, this is early.
Beautiful.
Now, we don't know how much of this we're going to do, because the song is about 10 minutes long.
But listen, we're with you guys.
Where are you going? You're not well yet.
What do you want to sing?
No, I don't sing it. You
want to
sing it?
Go there.
Love, it seems I just can't find.
Love,
it seems I just can't find. It seems that I'm the one love left behind.
I said I'd never do this. Sing about it.
Say, love, it doesn't come my way. It's the best bits to come. It gets better. A search doesn't come my way. It's love that I want more. So what can I say?
It's talent here.
But they're in bed, are they?
Yeah, there's...
Oh, no, they'll watch this, won't they, see if we mess up.
Should we mess it up then?
No.
I might do.
Quite long.
They can all Ukrainian.
And it goes like that, and it goes on.
It goes on.
I was good.
It does have that sort of flavour about it, though. Yeah, it's got a gypsy-fied type thing about it, yeah.
I'm just funny. It's
incredibly early to do something
like that. Tribute to them, do they? Did they ever knew Gerdundula?
No, they got divorced in the end. Very soon after we sort of knew them. They were the darlings of this town that we used to hang out in a lot. Well, one was a darling, wasn't she?
Well, yeah, she was.
I quite like Gert myself, but never came to much.
You like Eamon as well. I'm getting a bit worried about
a big day. I'm having a big day.
My partner, you know.
You always make it look, I mean, you're always a pleasure to talk to and interview down through the years, goodness me, but because you make it fun. I mean, you really do go out there. I mean, if you weren't enjoying it, you wouldn't be doing it.
No, we have fun and we try to make it look like we're having fun because that appears better. But we do actually enjoy doing the set, so...
Good. Well, now that we've got you out of bed, it would be a good idea to make you see, because we're going to talk about the Beatles later, aren't we?
Yeah, we've got the Rolling Stones.
And the Rolling Stones. And they've been going longer than you, apparently.
Yeah, apparently.
You can correct us on that later, but we're going to be talking about their new dates for the UK and whatever. So you stay with us, lads, and we'll talk about that?
Certainly.
In about 20 minutes' time.
That's it. And we're also going to talk about holidays, which I know it's not very good, is it? Really,
oh, we're going
you,
soon.
When do you get a holiday?
Straight after Christmas.
Oh, do you?
Yeah.
You're looking forward to that. Where are you going?
Yeah, I don't know yet. Where are you going?
I don't know. Maybe we can sort this one out. Anyway, if you like to go on a holiday, I don't know if the lads would enjoy this one, because it's very much a family holiday, and we're going to be talking about that in our Passport to Paradise competition. And it's actually
in Stones, July the 11th at Wembley. You can see them. Status Quo is still with us. Francis Rossi and Rick Parfitt. What's the appeal?
What, of them or us?
No, we know the appeal of you guys.
Mm. I don't know, really.
Wrinkles?
But they're legends, aren't they? I think maybe that's part of the appeal. I've never actually seen the Stones. I'd quite like to, but whether I'll get round to it, I don't know.
I think everybody keeps going, because I think this is probably the last time they'll
ever
see them.
Well, that's what they thought last time, though, didn't they? You know? But they seem to be, I don't know, they seem to be timeless a bit. You know, they just seem to go on, don't they? Like us a bit, really, I suppose.
But they would be what? They're nearly 10 years or so older than you guys,
yes,
aren't they?
Yes, they are. I thought I'd like to put that in. They're about 10 years older than us, you know.
Mm-hmm. They're in their 60s.
Yes. Yeah. Hang on, we lost out there, didn't we?
We did, rather, yeah.
Yeah. Well, they are older than us, I like to say that.
You know, as long as people are going along, and I mean, as long as they're still giving value for money, which I personally think is very important these days, you know, then great, good luck to him. And you know, Mick, you've got to admire him, really, the way he keeps himself so fit. I mean, he is a fitness fanatic, and I admire him for that. You know, can't quite say the same about Keith.
The stage show apparently is something else, what they've rigged up there on stage.
There's so much dough gone into it, but I mean, if they're playing the prestigious gigs like they are, they're playing the stadiums all over the world, I mean, and obviously, you know, you can afford to plough that much money into it if you're earning that much money back from it.
But you could see yourself. Could you see yourself still touring, you know, in 10 years from now?
Oh, sure.
Yeah?
Well, not right now.
It's sort of as long as people want to go along and want to go and see these concerts. Yeah. And we just had a few calls in, and there's a lot of youngsters who follow you. And I say youngsters, I mean, there's a boy here, Gary Holmes, no relation to Eamon, he's 10, and he says, I'm a great fan of Status Quo. Please say hello to him today. So there you go.
Hello, Gary.
This is like this, but they don't believe us. And
yeah, and then another guy here who's Richard Crane, who's 12, another fan. Yeah.
So much for the Stones there, but 30 years on, we've also got the Beatles.
Yeah, so we've got, it's Status Quo and the Rolling Stones, still going strong, but it's almost 25 years since their great rivals, the Beatles, split up. To all Beatles fans, this may come as a bit of a surprise. Well, that's a track from the new album from the Beatles, which goes on sale tomorrow. It's called The Beatles Live at the BBC. This is it, and it features over 56 songs, which may have never been heard before. It's quite amazing to think that there's so much material there that's never been put out.
Fascinating just to hear that. I mean, because we all, over the years, have thought that we've heard everything by the Beatles. I thought I had, anyway. To hear that, I mean,
it's all those early radio sessions that they used to do. They don't seem to do anymore. You said earlier they used to take bands in that didn't have contracts and stuff, and everybody would go in and do a session. And I remember we listened to it. The first one we did, I think, was with Brian Matthews at the these early Saturday morning BBC things.
Not as early as this, but it was early.
No, not silly early, just early, really.
So there could be undiscovered status quo stuff knocking about somewhere.
I hope not.
But there is.
Yeah.
Well, if there is, somebody will bring it out.
But I think
these cover versions like Johnny B. Good, the hippie shake, I mean, there's lots of stuff.
It's all cavern. They must have been doing all that stuff at the caverns all the early days.
I don't think there's any doubt that this will be massive, and whatever the single is going to be.
Yeah.
I stick my neck out. I reckon it'll go number one everywhere in the world.
You're probably right. Tower Records in London tonight is the place to be, because apparently at 2 a.m. this is when this goes on sale, and the first half dozen or so people through the doors get very special Beatles mementos. Francis and Rick will just finish in Ipswich, head down the motorway, and be queuing up there. But lads, thanks very much. Good luck with the rest of the tour.
Thank you.
And thanks for coming and talking
to us this morning.
Especially
Ipswich tonight.
Yeah.
It's going to be a good one.
Rocking Ipswich.